Blackstone presents Hotel California, an anthology of new mystery stories edited by Don Bruns. This book is read by Scott Brick, James Patrick Cronin, Joe Barrett, Joe Hempel, Sophie Amoss, Hilary Huber, Richard Ferrone, and January LaVoy. New Kid in Town by Andrew Child. Reacher expected a truck, but he wound up in a car. He expected to be kept waiting in the hot Texas sun, but he got a ride almost at once. He expected trouble when he saw a skinny guy in a suit stick his nose into someone else's business. And on that score, at least, he wasn't wrong. The rest area parking lot was maybe half full, but human behavior being what it is, the vehicles weren't evenly distributed. There were clumps of cars and trucks all bunched up together in some places, and other sections with three or four empty spaces in a row. The skinny guy had been about to climb into a silver sedan on the right-hand side of one of these gaps, 30 yards from where Reacher was standing. Another guy was heading for a dull blue pickup on the left-hand side. He would be in his late 20s, Reacher guessed, early 30s at the most. He wasn't especially tall, only around 5'10", but he was broad. His sleeveless t-shirt was stretched tight across his chest. His arms were thick. They were covered with a bright, swirling mass of tattoos. So were his calves, which bulged out below his knee-length shorts. He wore black boots, unlaced and gaping open. His head was shaved, and he was hurrying after a girl. She looked around 10 years old, with blonde hair in braids and a yellow sundress and sandals. She stretched for the door handle, then pulled her arm back and darted toward the rear of the truck. The tattooed guy grabbed her by the hair and pulled her back. "Dad!" The girl's voice was shrill. "Let go!" The skinny guy paused, one foot inside his car. He shifted his weight, set his foot back on the asphalt, turned to face the other man and the child. "Hey," he said, "stop that, you asshole! Let her go!" Reacher clamped the lid back down on his carry-out coffee cup and started to move. If it had been any other kind of dispute, a squabble over dinged paintwork, a contest for the most convenient parking spot, he might have left them to it. But this involved a kid. And as things stood, the way he saw them, there was no prospect of a happy ending. There were 25 yards between Reacher and the three people. The tattooed guy kept hold of the girl's hair for another couple of seconds. He was acting on his own timetable. He wanted that to be clear. Then he put his hand flat on her chest, slammed her against the side of the truck, and held her there for a few moments, as if the pressure would fix her in place. 15 yards between them. The skinny guy took a step, stiff and tentative. The tattooed guy took a bigger step, confident and aggressive. They locked eyes. Neither of them spoke. 5 yards. The skinny guy edged back. The tattooed guy moved forward. He raised his fist, cocked his arm. They were seconds away from game over. Moments away. Then Reacher stepped between them. In the car, Reacher said to the skinny guy. The guy didn't react for a moment. He was too shocked. The giant, messy figure in front of him seemed to have appeared out of nowhere. 6'5". 250 pounds, chest like a refrigerator, arms like most people's legs. He could have been a villain in a horror movie, or the thing you run from in a nightmare. Then the guy's senses kicked in, and he scrambled backward and did what he'd been told. Reacher turned to the girl in the truck. She climbed up onto the step, pulled open the door, jumped inside, and disappeared from sight. "Your kid?" Reacher said to the tattooed guy. The guy didn't answer. He glared back, but he did lower his fist, which was smart under the circumstances. "Want to keep her?" The guy strode forward. "You're not taking..." Reacher shoved him back one-handed. "Do you want to keep her?" The guy raised his arm again and took a wild swing. He was aiming for the side of Reacher's head. Reacher leaned back and watched the guys.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.